Hello, Covenant Kids. I'm so glad you could join me again this week. Let's dive into our worship time by reciting our remember verse. Our remember verse comes from John 3, verse 16, and it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." Let's put some actions to that now. God is when we put our hand out and land in front of our face. Loves, we cross our hands and just press them against our chest. Loves. World is where we have three fingers looking like a W on each hand, and we tap them on top of each other, spin them around, and land on back again. That's world. Sun is where we kind of cradle our arm like this, like as though we're holding a baby, and have our hand up here by our forehead and bring it down to rest on top of our baby. That's sun. And believes is where we cup our hand like this, start with one hand pointing at our forehead, turns into a C, and then cups the other hand. Okay, so believes. Perish is where we have one hand facing up, one hand facing down, and it just flips like this. That's perish. Then we have life, where we have two thumbs, and then we just bring them up. So life. All right, let's stand up and let's say it all together with the actions. Are you ready? All right. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. John 3, verse 16. That's great. Good job. All right, let's dive in with a song now, okay? This song is Let's Praise the Lord, and I'm pretty sure you know this song, but it might be just a little bit of a different version. Let's stand up and sing.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Story. Let's prepare our heads and our hearts and our hands. Okay, so we're going to breathe in real deep together. Ready? And in. And out. In. And out. I think we're ready to hear that story. All right, let's take a look at our story symbol for today. But I have a feeling you're going to probably guess this one. Here we go. What do you see here that might provide you with clues about today's story? What do you see? You see some fish and some bread. Does that give you an idea? Let's listen closely to this story to see what story this symbol represents. Our story for today comes from John 6, verses 1 to 13. Everywhere Jesus went, people followed him. Crowds gathered to see him and to hear him teach and to have him touch or heal them. On this day, the crowd was huge. People just kept coming and coming and coming. There were grandpas, grandmas, moms, dads, big kids, little kids, and even little babies. There were too many people to count. I wonder if you've ever seen a really big crowd of people like that. What was that like? Was it noisy? Was it crowded? Was it exciting? Everyone was so excited to hear Jesus. They all gathered in close to listen and watch. Lunchtime came and went, and the people were still listening to Jesus. Supper time came, and still they watched and listened. But at last, the great crowd of people around Jesus began to feel a rumbling in their tummies. Children asked their parents for food. Babies began to whimper. But there was a problem. Nowhere on that grassy hill was there enough food to feed such a great crowd of hungry people. Do you suppose there was a McDonald's around that they could all order in some French fries and cheeseburgers? I don't think so. Jesus asked his disciples, "Where shall we buy bread for these people?" Philip said, "Place near here that sells bread, but how can we pay for it? It would take a lot of money to buy each person here just one bite of bread." The disciples were worried and began to look everywhere for someone who might have some food. Finally, Andrew found a small boy who had taken his lunch with him. He was a smart boy. Andrew asked the boy if he would bring his lunch to Jesus. The boy said that Jesus could have his lunch, even though it was very small. Any guesses about what was in the boy's lunch? Any guesses? Just 5 little loaves of bread and 2 fish were in the lunch the boy had brought. A small lunch for one little person. Andrew didn't think this tiny lunch would help, but Jesus took it and said, "Tell everyone to sit down." Then Jesus opened the boy's lunch and took out the bread and fish. Jesus held up the food and thanked God for it. Then, as that great crowd watched, he began to break the food into pieces, putting it into the baskets for the disciples. Without saying a word, the disciples passed the bread and the fish to the grandpas, to the grandmas, the mums, the dads, the big kids, and the little kids, and even some of the older babies who sat there waiting and watching. Everyone ate and ate and ate. There was so much food that everyone in that great crowd had plenty. And all from the little lunch that was just big enough for one small boy. I wonder how Jesus could feed so many people from one little lunch. How was he able to do that? What do you think? When everyone had finished eating, Jesus said, "Pick up all the food that is left. Let nothing be wasted." So the disciples took their baskets and gathered every piece of bread that was left over. And can you imagine what they brought back? How many leftovers do you think there might have been after all these people had eaten from 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread? 12 baskets full of leftover bread. 12 baskets. Lot of leftover bread from such a little amount. Jesus had made the one little lunch into much more than enough for one small boy, and even much more than the great crowd could eat. Only Jesus could do such a miracle. Everyone knew that Jesus cared about each hungry person in that great crowd. Jesus cares about you too, He cares about you very much. I would like for us to pray together right now. I prepared a prayer, and I'm going to pause so that you can repeat each line after me. Are you ready to talk to God? Let's fold our hands, let's close our eyes, and bow our heads. Repeat each line after me.
Thank you, Jesus, for giving us good food to eat every single day, for bread and fruit, for milk and meat. Thank you, God, we pray. Amen.
God always provides for us because he cares about us. Take a look at that symbol card. Did you guess when Jesus fed the great crowd when he saw this fish and bread? You're pretty smart. Now you're going to go into your family groups, and we are going to be looking at this story card here. Number 94 matches the symbol. You're going to roll your dice. I've got dark blue. Dark blue. Do you see that? So mine says, retell. Write each number from the story on a separate slip of paper. Put the slips in a bowl. Take turns pulling out a paper slip, reading the number, and then telling which part of the story it is from. Well, that sounds like fun. See if you can remember all the little details if you did that one, right? Okay, one more thing for us to do. Did you guess where Andrew was hiding last week? How about this week? Andrew, where have you been hiding this week? Let's look at the picture. Here it is. And here are your clues, Covenant Kids. Number one, there are lots of books, a desk, and a chair here. Number two, people get together for devotions, prayer, and staff meetings here. The staff at Covenant Church are Pastor Michelle, myself, Mrs. Jen, and Mrs. Shelley, who sits in the office, and Mrs. Vandenduel, who is our worship director. That's where we sit and have our staff meetings. Number three, Pastor Michelle prepares her sermons here. That means that's the place where she writes her sermons and does all kinds of other work too. Where's Andrew? Okay, so send in your guesses to me. You can ask your parents to text me or email me or even phone me and let me know what your guess is. And your name will be entered into a draw to win lunch at McDonald's. Yum. Okay, gang, we've got one more song to sing. And this one is called Ask, Seek, Knock. It's a song about how much God really does care about us and will always provide for us. All right? Have a great week, gang. We'll see you next week.
I'm reading my B-I-B-L-E, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. And how Jesus came down to us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. Let's go! When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. He cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. Oh, oh, oh. I'm reading my B-I-B-L-E, and this is what it says to me. It tells me that I'm never, ever alone. To us and gave his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. Let's go. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you seek, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. Up.